It's cold.
A little chilly down here in Florida today. It was down to freezing last night. But I tell you what, I think about my home up in West Virginia. All of you from Indian Matters, God bless you. I miss you. I miss my family. I miss my church. Snow is up on the mountain today. It's supposed to get a little more. I can see our church up there with the snow on the roof, the snow on the steeple. I can see our home with the snow. And I get a little homesick from time to time. But you know, I'm really getting homesick for a place called heaven. A place that's where the roses never fade. A place that's where there'll be no more pain and sorrow. A place where there'll be no more brokenness. A place where there'll be no dying. Pastor Nikki's been dealing with high blood pressure. Something she's never dealt with before. And I know that part of it is staying up day and night with me. By the way, I'm getting better. I'm doing therapy and getting stronger every day. Sort of like if you read your Bible and pray, you'll get stronger spiritually every day.
That's right.
I'm getting stronger every day. We'll be moving to our new home in Salt Springs in a couple weeks. But I'm looking forward to when the weather breaks and the water gets turned on in West Virginia.
Yes.
That we can come home. We can come home.
Amen.
But today, beautiful day in Jacksonville, Florida. It's cold. But you know what? With Jesus, you can be warm.
Yes.
I just thank him for his mercy and his grace. I thank him that he has a good plan for all of his people.
Yes.
And God has a plan for you.
Amen.
A good plan.
A good one.
So I say to you today, don't give up the ship. By the way, that old ship of Zion may be rocking and rolling in the storm. And you know, the sails may be torn and tattered. But you know what? Just stay on board. Stay on the ship. And realize that God, I mean, he's the captain. He's going to bring that old ship of Zion right on to the banks of Glory Land.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Oh, God, we just love you and praise you today. Father, we come to you in Jesus' name, thanking you, Lord, for another day that you've given us. I thank you for the healing that's taking place in my body.
Amen.
And I thank you for the healing that's taking place in all of your people. If we'll just turn to you, Lord.
Yes.
I pray for those that are sick. Father, I pray today for the Wilsons. I pray, God, you'll help our brother get home. I love him so much. We sat and had so many good talks. Lord, let him know there's a better place. Help his wife and family. Help his wife and family to know that it's appointed unto a man once to die and then the judgment. I know where my brother's, he's going to be in heaven. And that brings me great joy that I could be a small part in his life walking with you, Jesus. And I pray for those that are down and depressed. For those that are suffering with anxiety, for those that are even contemplating suicide, God, we ask you to strengthen them today.
Yes.
We pray for our family in the body of Christ. God, that we will get on board.
Yes.
That all is not lost.
No.
And that all the things that's happening around us is only to bring us closer to you.
Yes.
And the closer we get to you, Father, the less we worry about what's going on in this world.
Amen.
Now, your word says that there's a day coming when this earth, everything we know, will be destroyed by fire.
Right.
And so, Lord, we're looking for not a temporary home, but a permanent home with you.
Amen.
To be in your presence. Now let your anointing power of the Holy Ghost be with us today.
Yes, Lord.
As we give the good news.
Amen.
God, that you are still God, that Jesus Christ is Lord of all, and that if we have a need, we can come to you, and you will supply that need according to all of your riches in glory.
Amen.
Father, I pray right now for those that have lost loved ones, not only to the COVID, but people are dying every day.
Yes.
I pray that through the passing of our loved ones, that we can come and draw nigh to you.
Yeah.
And you said, if I be lifted up, I'll draw all men unto you. And right now, we lift you up, Lord.
Yes, Jesus.
And we declare that you are the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, and that you are able to do exceedingly far above all that we ask or think. We love you and we humbly bow before your throne and say, have mercy on us, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
And forgive us.
Mm-hmm.
Forgive us where we failed you.
Amen.
In Jesus' name. And let everybody say,
amen.
Amen, Pastor Nikki.
Amen.
This old song was written by a man that was born in 1820. Went to be with the Lord in 1915. This is a song by Fanny J. Crosby. Not a man, but a woman.
My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but holy on Christ the solid rock I stand on.
We've got our motorhome behind us out here on our deck, and I'm watching the sun go down. And I always ask myself, when I see the sun going down, Lord, have I given you my best today?
Amen.
Sometimes I feel like I have, and sometimes I don't. But you know, God loves me either way.
Yes, He does.
And so when I feel like I failed the Lord, I just go to Him and say, Lord, remember, I'm only human.
Amen.
And you know, we as humans need the Lord.
We sure do.
And so when you come to Him and acknowledge your need for Him, whether you've done good or you've not done good, when you acknowledge your need for Him and that you're truly sorry for making the bad choices or making the mistakes or not just appreciating Him enough, you know what? He takes care of every disappointment.
He sure
Pastor
does.
Nikki, you got a good message for us today?
Always. The Word of God is full of good messages.
You know, it's amazing to have a godly wife, your best friend, and to have someone that you can always count on. And then, for her to be my pastor. I tell you, God's been good to me.
Me too.
You got some good work?
Yes.
Okay.
And He's my pastor.
Amen.
The other day, I was scrolling through Facebook, and a woman on there said, pray for me. I'm not sure that I'm saved. I am so full of fear. And I thought, oh, I just wish I could spend some time talking to her and telling her what I went through when I first became a Christian. You know, I believe that Satan tries to keep all of us kind of up in the air, not sure of our salvation, fearful, doubtful, wondering, did we do something to displease the Lord? Are we lost eternally? And I think back to a time I'd been saved about, maybe a year. And I was invited to a church. And I was given a tract as I left the church. And I went home and I read their information. And it said that you must be born again to be sure you're saved eternally. And I thought, well, that's true. And the tract went on to say that you must be filled with the Spirit of God, and if you're filled with the Spirit of God, you will speak in tongues. And if you don't speak in tongues, you're not born again, and you're on your way to hell. Oh, beloved, I went through such torment that night. I went to bed, maybe slept a couple of hours, and I woke up just full of anxiety. And I went to the sofa, I went downstairs, and I tucked myself into the cushions in the sofa, and I pulled out the Word of God. And I realized that it said nothing about having to speak in tongues to prove that you were born again.
Amen.
I learned the truth through the Word of God, and I wanted to say to that woman on Facebook, dig into the Word of God, know what it says, and stand on it, because Satan will always try to keep us off balance, to keep us worried, to keep us fearful and doubtful,
yes,
so that we can't be strong Christians and tell the world the truth. That Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. And so I got into the Word, and I want to share with you today one of the scriptures that I wrote out and tucked in my pocket. And it was John 3:16. For God so loved the world. For God so loved Nikki Stanley. For God so loved you, that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever, I'm a whosoever, are you a whosoever? Yes, you are. Whoever believes in the Lord Jesus be saved will not perish but have everlasting life. And I hung on to that verse. And then, as I was reading in the book of John, I came across the verse where Jesus says this, John 5:24. Write this down. Write a little note card to yourself. Put it in your pocket. Jesus said, verily, verily, he means truly, truly, I'm telling you the truth. I say unto you, he that heareth my word and believeth on him, on God the Father, that sent me, hath everlasting life, and shall not come into condemnation, but is passed from death unto life.
Yes, amen.
Oh, those words were so, so comforting to me. And I said, I can stand on that. You know, people, we sometimes count on our feelings. Do we feel like we're saved? Do we feel like we're one with the Lord? Do we feel like Jesus loves us? You can't go by feelings.
No.
You have to go by the Word. And we can go to the Lord and say, Jesus, have I done anything to separate me from you? Would you show me? Would you bring me back into unity? Would you bring me back into the truth? Bring me back into assurance. Help me to see who I am in you, Lord Jesus. The scriptures say in 1 John 1:9, if we confess our sins,
yes,
he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. And so, as I read through the Word some more, this was 40 years ago. I've been a Christian now for 42 and more years. And I've come to realize that my Lord Jesus is never going to let me go. He made a covenant with his blood. When he died on that cross, he said, Nikki, I am paying the price for your sin. I have wed you to myself. I have redeemed you by my blood if you will believe and receive. And I did. I believed and I received the blood of Jesus Christ, his gift of eternal life. And I know that I'm eternally saved. And it's a relationship. I'm in a covenant with him.
Yes.
The word covenant, look it up, beloved. The word covenant says it can never be broken. And Jesus, as he had the Passover meal with his disciples, said, showed them his blood as a, when he lifted the cup of wine to share with the disciples, he said, this represents the blood of the new covenant. He has made a promise that he will love us and keep us and save us and keep us close to himself. And I love Isaiah 49:15-16. Listen to this. 49. Can a woman forget her suckling child that she should not have compassion on the son of her womb? No way. Yea, they may forget, yet will I not forget thee. Behold, I have graven thee upon the palms of my hands. Thy walls are continually before me. Beloved, you are graven upon the palms of the Lord Jesus' hands. He died on that cross and paid the price. Those nails went into his hands, and he was thinking about you and me and the entire world that he cared about and loved, and he paid the price for the sins of the whole world in those hands. And we are graven on those hands. I heard the story of a woman that was fearful of her. She wasn't sure she was saved, and she went to a pastor, and she told him, "I'm not sure that I'm saved." And he noticed that she had written things on the palms of her hands. And he said, "What do you have written on your hands? Why do you write on your hands?" And she said, "So that I'll remember." And then that pastor told her about Isaiah 49:16-17. And he said, "Yet will I not forget you. I have graven thee upon the palms of my hands."
Yes, Lord.
And that woman,
yes,
from that day left the pastor's office rejoicing that she was written on the palms of the Lord Jesus Christ. Oh, he loves you. Beloved, be sure of your salvation. Seek him with all of your heart. Get into the Word. That is your foundation. The Lord,
yes,
Jesus Christ and what he has said in his Word.
Yes.
You cannot go by your feelings. You must go by the Word of God. And if there's any sin between you and the Lord, he will reveal it and bring it out, because he loves you and he wants to draw you close to himself and he wants to forgive you. He is full of mercy and love and forgiveness. I want to give you a few more scriptures to stand on. Romans 10:9 says this, that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and shalt believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be,
yes,
saved.
Yes, amen.
For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation.
Yes, Lord.
I remember when I first confessed that the Lord Jesus had saved me, I'd had this wonderful, wonderful encounter with God the Father, showing me the sin in my life and my need for a Savior, and that Jesus had forgiven me. And I asked Jesus into my heart to be Lord of my life, to take over, and to be, I just wanted to be one with him. And beloved, I have learned over these 42 years to walk with him, talk with him, be close to him, intimate with him, surrendered to him, that in him I have life and life more abundant.
Yes.
It is wonderful to walk with the Lord Jesus, to know that you're safe in his arms, his everlasting arms.
Yes.
He will never, never turn his back on you. Only you have the free choice to turn away from God. And who would do that, knowing that apart from him, we have no chance of having everlasting
life?
That's
right.
No chance that apart from him, we would suffer in hell through choosing on our own to turn away from the one who loves us the most, who has created us, who wants family. Oh, beloved. And then go to the book of 1 John to encourage yourself in the Lord. I want to read you a few scriptures there in 1 John before I run out of time here. But the book of 1 John, I read it over and over and over to get it into my spirit that I was safe eternally. Well, 1 John 4:13-19 says this. 13-19. Hereby know we that we dwell in him.
Yes.
And he in us.
Yes.
Because he hath given us of his Spirit.
Yes.
Beloved, you recognize when you're born again that your life is totally changed. You've come out of darkness into light.
Yes.
You
Amen.
Have a desire to please the Father, to love him with all of your heart, and to love other people. And you care about the lost. Don't doubt your salvation when you have the Spirit of God in you. And we have seen and do testify that the Father sent the Son to be the Savior of the world. Whosoever shall confess that Jesus is the Son of God, God dwelleth in him, and he in God. Only the Spirit of God can reveal to you that Jesus is the Son of God, come in the flesh to die for your sin. And we have known and believed the love that God hath to us. God is love, and he that dwelleth in love dwelleth in God, and God in him.
Yes, amen.
Herein is our love made perfect, that we may have boldness in the day of judgment.
Yes.
Because as he is, so are we in this world. There's no fear in love, but perfect love casteth out fear, because fear hath torment. He that feareth is not made perfect in love. Seek the Lord Jesus. When you see his love for you, you can be perfected in that love and cast fear away, cast fear aside. We love him because he first loved us.
Yes, amen.
I can remember back when I read that tract that said I wasn't born again if I didn't speak in tongues, because then I didn't have the Spirit of God. When I read that, I said, well, Lord, if I'm not saved, I'm still going to serve you anyway. And the Lord just grew me, helped me to become stronger in the truth, to stand on the Word of God. I, as a mother, would no more put aside my son and forget him and cast him away from me than Jesus would cast us away from him. He has made a covenant with him, a promise that he will never break.
Yes.
And why would we break that covenant? Why would we leave him, the one who loves us so much? So, beloved, if you're wondering about your salvation,
yes,
I pray for you today. Let's go to the Father in prayer right now. Father, I pray for anyone that's listening that's not sure of their salvation.
Yes.
That they will seek your face with all their heart. And I know, Father, that you will teach them. You will show them your word. You will show them that they are safe eternally.
Yes.
As they continue to walk with you, Lord Jesus, to trust you, to lean on you, to follow hard after you, to walk with you in a marriage of the Lamb of God. Oh, it's wonderful that you have made a promise to us that'll never be broken. And Father, I know that all of us who have come to know that Jesus is our Savior, that we will never turn away from him, and that we are looking forward to the day when he will come for us and we will be with him eternally. Thank you, Father, for assurance of our salvation. Amen.
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 There's a sweet song by Fanny Crosby that talks about blessed assurance. She knew that she was saved.
Wow, what a good word. And you may be one of the people that God's talking to tonight, today. I don't know if I'm saved or not. Well, let me tell you. God wants you to go to bed tonight when you lay your head on your pillow.
Yes.
And know it as well.
Amen.
How can I do that? By believing that God Almighty sent his son to take your place in death, hell, and the grave.
Amen.
And that by his shed blood, that your sins will be forgiven.
Yes.
Does it come automatic? No, you have to ask for it.
Yes.
You have to have a heart that says, I don't want to do anything that's not pleasing to God, my Creator. So if you've got a doubt in your mind, would you pray from your heart?
Yes.
From your mouth ain't going to get it. It's got to come from your heart up through your mouth.
Yes.
And just say, Heavenly Father, I believe that you sent your son Jesus to save me from my sin.
Yes.
And sin will take me to hell.
Yes.
sin brings nothing but torment.
Yes.
Sin separates me from you.
Yes.
And I ask you to remove that sin out of my life.
Yes.
And let your sweet spirit come into my body, and my heart, and my soul, and show me how I can please my God, the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, all my days here upon the face of this earth.
Yes.
Save my soul, Lord, and write my name in the book of life.
Mm-hmm.
It's a done deal.
Done deal.
You're all in.
Amen.
Now follow Jesus with all of your heart.
Amen.
We just love you and thank you for joining us today. See you tomorrow, Lord willing.
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine, heir of salvation, purchase of God. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. Well, now this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long,
all the day long. Perfect submission, perfect delight,
perfect delight, delight.
I love you.
This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story.
I need to be
lost in his love.
Lost.